Hi everyone, in this video for part 3 of direct kinematics on robotics, we will be looking at creating transformation matrices from the values in a DH table. Now in my previous video, we looked at creating a DH table from the frames assigned for a given robotic manipulator. If you're not quite familiar on how this works, check it out by clicking the link up here. Don't forget to give me a thumbs up, and if you haven't done so already, please hit that subscribe button. I'm Chums, and welcome to That's Engineering. Alright, so when creating transformation matrices from the DH table, this is the equation that we will be using. So in this equation, C would be cos, and S would stand for sine values. And as you can see, the variables used are the same link joint parameters that are there in the DH table. We have AI minus 1 over here. We have alpha I minus 1, DI, and theta I. And all we need to do is substitute these values into this equation to get our transformation matrix. Alright guys, so using this equation is best understood through an example. This is the robotic manipulator that we've been looking at through these past three videos. And in the first video, we assigned the frames to this manipulator. And in the second video, we found its DH table. Now, we will use the values in the DH table to find its transformation matrices. For the DH table, when we created it, we moved from one frame to another. We went from 0 to 1, then 1 to 2, and 2 to 3. And these are the exact same frames we will be using to find our transformation matrix from one frame to the other. So let's have a look at it. Here we only need the values from the DH table, so we really have no need for this diagram or to refer this diagram anymore. Right, so the first step would be to create our transformation matrix, frame 0 to 1. So in this case, I becomes equal to 1. Right, so cos theta I, take the values from the first row, theta I is 0, so we have cos 0 minus sine 0. We have 0, and AI minus 1, which is also 0. Then we have sine 0, cos alpha I minus 1 is this value, that's also 0, cos 0, cos 0, minus sine 0, minus sine 0, and DI is D1. Then we have sine 0 again. We have cos 0 into sine 0, cos 0, and cos 0 into D1. And finally 0, 0, 0, and 1. And if we were to simplify this transformation matrix, we should get 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, D1, and 0, 0, 0, 1. So this is our transformation matrix moving from frame 0 to frame 1. It's very simple. All you need to do is just substitute in the values from the DH table into this equation. Right, so in the next step, we can find our transformation matrix 1 to 2 considering the second row of the DH table. So all you need to do is substitute the values into the equation and you should get this as your matrix. You can do this for the final matrix, transformation matrix 2 to 3, and you would get this as your final answer. Now, if you take a look at this matrix, you would see that it is the exact same matrix we discussed in the first few videos. This section shows the position of the manipulator, while this section, this 3x3 section, shows the orientation. If you look at this 3x3 section, you would see that it is a rotation about the Z axis. And this is true because the second joint was a revolute joint with its axis running through Z, in the Z direction. So you can imagine why this 3x3 section is a rotation around the Z axis. While for the first joint, it was a prismatic joint, and so you didn't really have this sort of an equation. Right, so let's go through a quick summary on what we learned in these past few videos for the direct kinematic section. So first, for any robotic manipulator, we have to assign the frames or the coordinate systems to each of the joints for the robot. And when we do this, we have six conventions that we follow. This involves looking at the joint axes and the axis of rotation. So we have our right-hand rule that we have to take into account. And if we need our y-axis for completion, we will look at our left-hand rule as well. After the frames have been assigned, we can then form our DH table based on our four link joint parameters. So we have alpha I minus 1, we have AI minus 1, DI, and theta I. From the DH table we saw in this video, we can make our transformation matrix using these four link joint parameters that we got from our DH table. So here, to do this, we have an equation which you can simply follow. After this, we actually go back to what we did in our first few videos on spatial descriptions and transformations. So you can do your matrix algebra. For example, in this question, we found three transformation matrices. If you wanted the transformation matrix from frame 0 to frame 3, we can simply multiply each transformation matrix together that we just found to get this final answer. Alright guys, so that's all for this video. If you guys liked it, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button below. If you have any questions or clarifications on the work I just did to find the transformation matrix using the DH parameters, please feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to you. I hope this video helped, and if you haven't done so already, go ahead and click that subscribe button right now. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you all in the next video.